welcome to part one of my complete beginner's model horse customizing tutorial. So on part one, I will be going through however many 9 minutes can go through, like the essentials and all the supplies that you need. So first off, I'm not going to jabber, brushes. Brushes are really important, and you have to get good brushes, because artists have to have good brushes, and even if they're expensive, they're worth buying. So I just bought some good brushes, and these are the same type. They're camel hair. They were $12, and I know that's expensive, but they work really well. They're poofy. They're camel tip size, 1/4 inch, and they're Lowell Cornell. It says mini mop, but they work really well. You can blend a lot, and you can also, you know, do it away a little bit. And this is a big mop brush, which is also an essential for getting the extra powder. This one was like $2. This one was really cheap, and it's for brushing away the extra pastel dust. This is a size 6 Filbert American Painter brush, and it can be used for acrylic and also for shading the muscles. And not many people talk about muscle shading brushes, but I will in this tutorial. And it can also be used for acrylic. And this one was $10, I think. And then a detail brush, which is a very big essential. You can see there. And it's for doing little details on the eyes, on the hooves, and all that good stuff, all the little detailed markings. So, essentials are brushes. And I'll put a list of them in the description box. In this video tutorial, we'll be using pastels. There's many ways to customize model horses, but as a beginner, pastels would be the very easiest. Another essential that you'll need is an earth tone colored pastel set. Earth tones you cannot buy in Michael's or anywhere except for if it's online. You can find it in some art stores. But this kind is the Alpha Color 12 Set Soft Pastels Earth Tones. And make sure you get soft pastels because the hard tends to not stick to the horse. If you can't find this, you can always find these at your local Michael's or art store. I started with these, and all of my cousins have been used with this set. I have just found this set in my mom's art kit, and she said I could have them. Later on, after using this, I used gray scales. I used gray scales for my gray horses and other horses that were blue roans, like this one. So once you get more in and make sure that you like the hobby and more into customizing, you could purchase a gray scale. This one is, of course, unorganized, like my whole entire life, but it has the main essentials. You have yellows, cream colors, tans. You can see that I use the tan a lot. It looks orange, but you can see I use the tan a lot because it's a very common color. And there's reds for chestnuts, dark browns, blacks, and a gray. So that will get you started, but I would recommend looking for this before buying this. See, this one has all the light colors for palominos, chestnuts, bays, duns, paints. And there's a black, but it's covered in brown. So, those are your pastel sets. And the price range for these, this one was $7. This one, I think, was around $10 because it has all these colors that we don't normally use. But the good thing about this one is that it has the blues for roans and the more reds for red roans. And when you first start, you won't be doing roans, so that's why this one would be a good choice. And also, you can buy pastels in individual sticks, so you don't have to buy a whole entire set if you just need, like, a blue or a red. The next thing you'll need is acrylics. Acrylics are essential for markings and eyes and hooves. Some good colors to have are black, white. White is definitely an essential. You must have this to put markings on your horse, such as the blaze, the stockings, and all that good stuff. Red is used to create a pink color for pinking around eyes. A nutmeggy color, a nutmeg folk art, That's the kind that I have. It's good use, good for eyes. A dark chocolate brown. This one's empty, so I have to get a new one. I got two shades of gray for, because I'm developing a technique for sponging when I'm doing my dappling, and it's also good for eyes when you're creating blues. And that's about it for the acrylics. And these, the folk art, I think they're about $1 a bottle. You can get fancier ones that are more expensive, but they're not that bad, so they're not too expensive. And this one, my old white was also folk art, just I ran out. So I have the Sargent art. And this works actually pretty good because it's kind of watery, but not too watery. So that's what you will need for acrylics. Another thing that isn't exactly an essential, but nice to have, is a Sharpie paint pen used for signing your models. It's pretty much just a fine tip paint pen that you use. I've been practicing here, as you can see, that you use to write your initials and the date of when you finished your model. I use Extra Fine Point Black and the Sharpie brand, and it says paint.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.